What's up, mobile devs? I hope you're doing well. In this tutorial, unfortunately, we are not going to recreate this typical animation, but don't be too worried because I already made a video about this checkbox interaction and you can find it in the video description. So the point of this tutorial instead will be to be much more focused on a couple of very common problems while dealing with React Native and React Apps. So the first problem is dealing with a shared state. So let's see what we have right there. We have a home tab and we have a selected tab. And in the selected screen, we can see that we are somehow visualizing the same highlighted labels that were highlighted in the home tab. So this is a very common problem to solve with React Native and React. And you can use the context APIs, you can use any state management option. But in this specific tutorial, we are going to use Jotai, which is my favorite state management option, honestly. It is extremely simple and very, very powerful. And I, of course, I heavily recommend it for building your own apps. The second issue that we are going to solve instead is going to be the data persistence. So let's see that practically. Here, I'm going to reload the app. And by magic, let's say the data is going to be persisted across multiple sessions. This one as well is a very common issue. Let's say you can use any storage option, but in this specific video, we are going to use React Native MMKV, which is, in my opinion, the best option to deal with the storage with React Native because it is extremely performant and very simple to use. So let's say about that, I also want to point out that we are not going to solve these two problems in a completely different way. We are going to use a combined version. So we are going to combine Jotai together with MMKV. And let's say we are going to create a custom solution to deal with this problem. Honestly, not something that I have invented. We are just going to copy and paste some code over their documentation. And by magic, everything is going to work smoothly. So before moving on, I also have to mention, of course, that Jotai has been created and maintained by Dai Shikato, who is an amazing developer. He is the maintainer of Zustand, Jotai, and Valtio, which are three outstanding state managements for React and React Native. And he is also the creator of Waku, which is a minimal React framework. And of course, I have to mention Mark Rusavi, who is the maintainer and creator of React Native MMKV. He is extremely talented and he has created React Native Vision Camera, React Native Blur Hash, React Native Graph, a lot, believe me, a lot of different React Native packages that you are probably using right now. So I highly recommend you to check out his GitHub profile and his Twitter account because you are going to get a tremendous amount of value by doing this couple of things. And that said, let's finally get our hands dirty and let's move on to the code part. So here, as you can see, we are not going to start this tutorial with an empty app, with an empty ExpoGo project, but we are going to start with something already there for us. So if you know my channel, you probably know that I always love to recreate things from scratch, but in this specific case, I don't think it is worth it. Actually, I highly recommend you to ignore completely this repo and to open your personal project, your or your company's project if you want to, and your company is very flexible, and to apply the same solution to the problems that very likely you are going to find on your own project as well. However, let's say, of course, I'm going to provide the link of the GitHub repo in the video description if you want to code along with me. And let's see what we have. Let's say at the beginning. So we have two tabs, the home tab and the select tab. And here, if we tap on the items on the home tab, we are not going to see the shared state on the selected tab. So these two screens are almost identical except for the title, and they are storing the state, they are handling the state in a local way, which is not shared at all. And let's say the second thing that you can see is that if we reload, the state is definitely not persisted across multiple sessions. So let's also try to see what we have on the code side. So we have these two screens created with the Expo router setup. Honestly, this solution is going to work perfectly also with React Navigation. But here I just choose Expo router because it is easier, honestly. and you can see the home screen and the selected screen. So here the code is very similar to the UI in a sense that, let's say, these two screens are identical. I'm just updating the title. So both of these screens are using the Use Cuisines hook, which is a very simple hook that is sharing a local state. So it is initializing a local state with the Use State hook from React. It is providing a toggle cuisine function, which is just, let's say, a function that it is needed in order to support this behavior, where you can toggle the item. And it is exporting the cuisines and the toggle cuisine function. So first of all, let's try to see what we want to do. So we have the home screen, we have the selected screen. Both are using the Use Cuisines hook, and the Use Cuisines hook is using a local state. And the point is that we don't want to use a local state, we want to use a shared state. How can we handle that? As mentioned previously, we are going to use Jotai. So in this tutorial, I already installed Jotai. You can see it in the package.json. I'm using the latest available version. Honestly, in the long term, I really think that the Jotai APIs are not going to change much. Probably the internal implementation will change. And this means that if you're looking at this video in, let's say, 2030, probably this is still a good tutorial to watch. So at least I hope that. So let's see what we want to do. Of course, we want to use something from Jotai, and more in detail, we want to use an atom from Jotai. So let's define this cuisines atom by using the atom function, which is imported from Jotai, and we are passing to this atom the initial state. So what is an atom? An atom is nothing more than a piece of state which can be accessed by all of your React components and even outside of your React components if you want to. And the point is that we are just creating some sort of reference. And we can easily use this atom by using the use atom hook from Jotai, which is almost identical to the use state, and by passing as the parameter the atom reference. So here, if we reload, you can see that we are already sharing the state. So this is literally two lines of code, which is pure magic in my opinion. So what's the deal? So first of all, the atom concept, I also want to point out that the atom concept was introduced by Recoil, which is another state management proposed by Facebook. Recoil and Jotai are very similar API-wise, but to be honest, I heavily prefer Jotai over Recoil just because the package is extremely lightweight and let's say it is very well maintained. So before jumping on handling the data persistence, let's try to filter the data on the selected tab. So what we can do is that we can define the filtered cuisines. We can use the filter function on the cuisines, and we can filter them by the selected property, which is a property available in the cuisine type. So let's pass these filtered cuisines. Let's jump on the selected screen. Let's replace these cuisines with the filtered cuisines. And let's just reload. And as you can see, we are supporting the filtering. However, I mean, I don't want to dive deep with Jotai, but I just want to let you see this interesting thing. So here we have used a very simple way of filtering items. This is the default way of filtering things. But the point is that we can also define a derived atom, which is going to listen for this cuisines atom, and it will filter automatically the data whenever the cuisines atom changes. So let's see the solution very quickly. So let's say filtered cuisines atom. This atom is, let's say, will be defined by using the common atom function as previously, but instead of passing an initial value, we are going to pass some sort of callback, which accepts this get function. And this is a getter that, as Copilot knows really well, we listen for the cuisines atom. And we are going to listen for the cuisines atom and filter the atom itself. At this point, we just need to read the data of this filtered cuisines atom. We can use again the use atom hook. Here, we are just interested in the first value. So we are, let's say the callback is not important in this specific case. And by reloading, Let's say everything is working as it was working previously. Honestly, let's say this is not easier than the previous solution, so why do we actually want to do that? I mean, first of all, this thing is memoized. The previous solution wasn't memoized, we should have used the useMemo hook. Second thing, which is much more important in my opinion, is the fact that in this specific case it doesn't really matter, but in a real use case scenario where you have a lot of atoms, a lot of components, if you listen just for this filtered cuisine atom, just for the derived atom, and the cuisine's atom, so the main one, changes, and the filtered cuisine, so the derived one, doesn't change, your component won't re-render, which is extremely important, let's say, for performance in general. So if you can use derived atom, I highly recommend to use them. Last but not least, in this specific case, we are using the useAtom, but we are not interested in the callback, so Jotai provides us an interesting hook called useAtomValue, and we can use it for our use case. So this is going to work as previously. So if we reload, as you can see, we are not handling the data persistence. So we have solved the first issue, but we need to solve definitely the second issue, which is the data persistence. How to do that? As mentioned previously, we are going to use React Native MMKV. So let's jump on the React Native MMKV README on GitHub. And here you can see something very interesting. So React Native MMKV, I love to use it because it is a synchronous storage option. And using synchronous things usually simplifies a lot the data handling. But the interesting thing is that it is actually 30 times faster, almost 30 times faster than async storage. And I'm claiming that because here, let's say the maintainer also provide a very interesting graph, which with some statistical significant result. I hope so. Let's say I think so, because he made the test 1,000 times on some specific devices. So honestly, I mean, I don't really care about the statistics here. Just trust the author, this package, and trust me, because this package is going to be really faster than, let's say, async storage and the other storage options. One important thing is that, let's say, you can't use, unfortunately, React Native MMKV with ExpoGo. So if you're using Expo, you need to pre-build. So you need to switch to a managed workflow, which is not really a blocker, in my opinion, because I highly recommend you to use the Expo managed workflow by default for your real apps. So in the documentation, you can find a lot of things, how to define the storage, how to have specified the encryption key, the path for the storage, how to set the items, how to retrieve the items from the storage, how to use some custom hooks. But I mean, these are all important things. But in our use case, we are just interested in the bindings with the state management. So if you scroll a bit more, you are going to jump on this section, which is the documentation. And you are going to find a bunch of links. Actually, MMKV can be integrated with a lot of different state managements, such as the Redux, Recoil, Mobex, Toolstand. In our specific case, we are interested in Jotai, so we are going to check this link. But little bonus, if you have followed so far, I also like to recommend you this solution using MMKV with React Query. If you are using React Query in your app, this is pretty powerful. But let's move forward to using MMKV with Jotai. And as you can see here, we have some snippet. I'm just going to copy this snippet and we are going to see it on Visual Studio Code, which is slightly easier. So let's create the states folder, the utils files, and let's just paste this snippet. And let's see what this snippet is all about. So after all, we have, we are importing MMKV, we are defining a storage with MMKV, and we are importing Atom with storage and create JSON storage from Jotai. And here we are exporting Atom with MMKV, which under the hood is nothing more than the Atom with storage function from Jotai. So the point is that Jotai is providing us this amazing add-on with storage option if you want to handle persistent on the data persistence on your Atom, but it doesn't specify the storage that you actually want. So you need to specify to Jotai, to this function, what's the storage you're interested in. In our specific case, we are interested in MMKV, but let's say Jotai is expecting a storage, which is an object that supports the clear all, remove item, set item, and get item function. MMKV have a slightly different API naming. So instead of get item, we have get string. Instead of set item, we have set dot delete, and that's it. So this snippet is just providing to us a mapper that is going to convert the rename, actually the functions from MMKV to the functions that Jotai is expecting. So that's really it. So we have this snippet, these utils, and let's just take this atom with MMKV. Let's jump on the usecuisines.ts file. Let's replace the current atom with MMKV, and nothing is going to work. I mean, TypeScript is complaining, and that's because the atom with MMKV supports two values. The first parameter is the storage key, and the second parameter is the initial value. So let's specify here the storage key. I mean, I'm just going to write storage key, cuisines storage key. Of course, feel free to use the naming that you want to use. And if we tap here and we reload, we are going to have the data persistence handling. But let's say, I mean, we are almost done, but I want to let you see this important thing. So let's select much more items. Let's reload. And here, fortunately, the animation is telling us that, of course, there is something weird that is happening under the hood. So you can see that if we reload and you look closely, there is definitely something weird. So what's weird right there? The point is that by default, when we reload, what is going to happen is that the atom is going to use the initial state as the initial parameter. And the initial state is basically this array of cuisines. And by default, all of these cuisines are not selected. However, let's say on the second state, Jotai is going to use the storage, is going to fetch the data from the storage, and it will, let's say, update the data with all our selected items. So here, of course, the ideal solution would be to, let's say, fetch directly the correct data from the storage and ignore the initial state. And the point is that we can actually solve that in a very quick and easy way by checking how the atom with MMKV is implemented. So here, as mentioned previously, we are just returning this atom with storage. And there is one hidden gem in the atom with storage, which is the fourth parameter. So we have a key, the storage key, we have the initial value, and we have the storage that we are passing. The storage can be asynchronous or synchronous. In our specific case, we are passing a synchronous storage. And then we have the fourth parameter, which is the options. So the options is just an object which has one property, the getOnInit property. So by default, the getOnInit property is equal to false. So you can see that if we set this property equal to false, we have the same identical behavior. But if we set the property to true, we have solved our problem. So let's try actually, of course, this is the end of the tutorial, but I just want to explain why the false is the default behavior. The point is that the maintainer of Jotai is assuming that you are using a storage option. By default, let's say the common solution in React Native also is async storage. The most popular solution is async storage, which is an asynchronous solution. If you are storing a lot of data and you have an asynchronous storage, which is also very slow, waiting for the storage data, waiting for the storage fetching before the app initialization is definitely a huge blocker, which is going to slow down a lot your app bootstrap. But the point is that right now we are using a synchronous storage. We are using MMKV, which is really fast. We are storing as, let's say, very few, a little object. We are just storing an array, and I highly recommend you just to use and store a very small piece of data. I mean, when I'm talking about a very small piece of data, I'm just talking about a few kilobytes, not megabytes. And I mean, if with all of these conditions, honestly, I recommend you to check this property to true, because it is going to simplify a lot the data handling. You don't have to deal with the storage, with the data hydration, and you are good to go with just this atom with MMKV. You can handle global state, and you can ensure data persistence worthy state, which is, in my opinion, pure magic, honestly. So that said, that was it for this tutorial. I really hope that you enjoyed this one, and if you have suggestions for coming content, future videos, feel free to let's say leave them in the section below. If you want to support me, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And that said, see you to the next one.